Hi children, welcome to Learning Made Easy. In this video, we're gonna learn punctuations. In English language, there are some symbols and signs known as punctuation. And we use punctuation marks to show the structure of a sentence and to change or modify the meanings of the sentences used. Likewise, punctuation marks are also used to read a sentence properly with proper pause and space. The first punctuation mark we're gonna learn is full stop. Full stop is used to mark the end of a sentence. Whenever you finish a sentence, you should give a full stop. And after the full stop, the next sentence which starts should have a capital letter in the beginning. Look at the example given here. Chloe went to the shop. She bought some sweets. Chloe went to the shop. It is the first sentence. At the end, I have given a full stop. And the next sentence begins. She bought some sweets. Even at the end of this sentence, I have given a full stop. Children, remember, each sentence should begin with a capital letter. The first sentence, Chloe went to the shop, begins with the word Chloe and the word starts with capital letter C. Likewise, after the full stop, the next sentence also begins with a capital letter. She bought some sweets. The first word she also starts with a capital letter. The next punctuation mark we're going to learn is comma. Comma is used to indicate a natural pause. It is used to give a natural pause while reading a sentence. Not only this, comma is used to separate items in a list. Look at the examples given here. In the first example, Stacy went to her friend Amy's house. She loves to go there. Here, I have given two pieces of information. The first information is Stacy went to Amy's house. And the second piece of information is she loves to go there. Since I want to use both the information in a single sentence, I am using comma to divide or to separate the information or to give a pause while reading these two information given in a single sentence. Look at the second example, children. Adam bought apples, bananas, pears and grapes from the market. Here, I am listing out many items. Apples, bananas, pears and grapes. Since I am using items in a list, to separate each item, I am using a comma. The next punctuation mark we are going to learn is question mark. A question mark is used at the end of a question. Look at the examples given here. How are you? It's a question. At the end of this question, I have used a question mark. The second example, how long is the bus journey to London from Cambridge? At the end of this also, I have used a question mark. The next punctuation mark is quotation marks. You can also call it as double quotation. Quotation marks are used to put direct speech inside it. While writing, this is very much useful. Look at the examples given here. When I am giving a direct dialogue, I am using quotation marks. See, I love to read a book, said Stacy. Here, Stacy's exact words. The dialogue is written. So, the dialogue is put inside quotation marks. Look at the second example, children. What did you do yesterday? Asked Lucy. Here again, Lucy's exact words are given. So, these words are put inside quotation marks. These exact words or dialogues are called as direct speech. So, whenever you use direct speech, you should use quotation marks. The next punctuation mark is parenthesis. You can also call it as round brackets. These round brackets are used to separate an extra information in the sentence. At the same time, you can use this also to emphasize an information. Emphasize give importance to the information. Look at the first example, children. On the weekends, I visit James. It is enough to leave with that. But I want to add the information that James is my best friend. So I am using these round brackets to give that extra information. I am covering this extra information with round brackets on both the sides. Look at the next example. Yesterday, Friday, was the last day of school. Here, I need not mention Friday in round brackets, but I want to emphasize that yesterday was Friday. I want to make it important that yesterday was Friday. So, I am using the word Friday within round brackets. So, round brackets are used to add extra information or to emphasize a particular information. Children, instead of using round brackets, you can also use commas. For example, we can remove the round brackets covering my best friend and we can just add a comma in front of the word my. On the weekends, I visit James, comma, my best friend. Even that would do. The next punctuation mark is square brackets. Children, like round brackets, square brackets are also used to cover or indicate extra information in the sentence. But this is mostly used by editors. I mean, it is mostly used in formal sentences or formal writings. Look at the example given here. The book states that when climbing it, mountain, it is important to be very safe. The word mountain is put inside square brackets. You need not write the word mountains because the word it denotes mountains, but the editor wanted it to be specific, so he added the word mountains within square brackets. So square brackets are also used to indicate extra information in a sentence. The next punctuation mark is exclamation mark. Children, I hope you know what is an exclamatory sentence. A sentence that shows strong emotions like surprise, shock, extreme happiness. Yes, these sentences are also called as dramatic statements. So, exclamation mark is used at the end of sentences or words which show dramatic expressions. When you say stop, you can say the word in shock, or you can command at someone, but it is an extreme emotion, right? So at the end, you can use exclamation mark. Look at the sentence given here, don't run into the road. It is actually a command with a dramatic effect, right? So at the end, I have used the exclamation mark. So an exclamation mark should be used at the end of any sentence or even a word which gives a dramatic effect. The next punctuation mark is slash. Slash is used to indicate the word or. You need not use the word or when you use slash. Look at the first example. Please explain to the lawyer when he or she arrives. The slash means or. When you read, you should read the slash as or here. Slash is also used to separate the day, month and year when you write a date. Look at the second example. The date today is 1-2-2017. 1 denotes the day. I'm using slash at the end of the day. And 2 denotes the month. After writing the number for month, I'm using a slash again to separate it from the year 2017. The next two punctuation marks we're going to learn are a colon and a semicolon. Let's start with children, you have to write 2 dots, one below the another, when you use a colon. Colons are usually used to introduce something, like giving a heading and then giving the list below. Look at the 3 places where you have to use colon. Whenever you introduce a list, you can use a colon. See here, the reasons for keeping the park are and I'm using a colon. Then I'm giving the list, the environment, recreation and appearance. And the second place is whenever you give an example. Look at the example given here. There are many types of vehicles. After using these words, I am giving a colon. Then I am giving examples for vehicles. Car, buses, trucks and motorcycles. Likewise, whenever you are going to give examples, you can use a colon. Look at the third place, an explanation. Whenever you are going to give an explanation for some information, you can use a colon. Look at the example, one result is inevitable. After giving these words, I am using a colon because I am going to give an explanation for the result. What result? Someone will eventually be injured. So, when you are going to give a statement and then an explanation, you can use a colon. Semicolon. A dot and then a comma below that. That's what you call a semicolon. You have to use semicolon when you are giving two sentences which are closely related. Look at the example given here. The computer had a virus. All the files were lost. Here I am using semicolon to denote that both the ideas are important and both the ideas are closely related. So, semicolon works like the sign given here and the meaning is both the ideas, both the pieces of information are important and closely related. The next punctuation mark is hyphen. Hyphen is a small dash used to join or to separate syllables in a word. Not only this, there are certain words which are conjoined and these words should always be used with hyphen. See the first example, she is very self-confident. Self-confident is a conjoined word and you must always use hyphen between these two words. Look at the second example, her son is going to be 4 years old. 4 years old is a phrase and these words are connected with hyphen. And in this case, you need not use the hyphen all the time. But in the first sentence, the word self-confident is used. The word self-confident is always used with a hyphen. The next punctuation mark is N dash. This is somewhat bigger than hyphen. This is used to indicate a period of time. And this is also used between range of numbers or distance. It is used like the word to. Look at the examples given here. She lived in London from 1999 to 2005. Here, I am using N dash instead of the word to and it denotes a period of time. It denotes the duration between 1999 and 2005. Look at the next example. The numbers range from 1 to 20. When I say 1 to 20, I am again speaking about a range of numbers. Here also the N dash is used to denote the word to. Look at the next example, children. The flight from Dubai to UK is very long. Here again I am speaking about distance from one destination to the other destination, from Dubai to UK. I am speaking about the distance between Dubai to UK. So, I am using the N dash instead of the word to here. The next punctuation mark is M dash. This is bigger than the N dash. This long dash, M dash, is used instead of a comma. Look at the first example. I can't wait to see Amy, my best friend, on Sunday. Here I am giving the extra information that Amy is my best friend. Here, usually we use commas. After Amy, there would be a comma. After my best friend, there would be a comma. Instead of using a comma, you can use this M dash. Look at the next example. My parents are visiting tomorrow. I have missed them so much. Here, usually we give colon. But instead of using a colon, you can use M dash. M dash is also used to improve readability, enhance readability. Whenever you have M dash, you have to give a short pause. With this, we have come to the end of the video, children. I hope you all would have enjoyed learning about punctuation marks. Try to practice using punctuation marks properly and reasonably in sentences, children. Thank you, children.